If you've been relying on Ozempic or Wegovy for significant results, you may be one of the people finding yourself disappointed when they don't meet your expectations. You've probably come across those exciting reports of 15 to 20% weight loss achieved by others, and you're left wondering why you're not experiencing anything remotely similar. While both Ozempic and Wegovy are effective for weight loss, there are certain pitfalls that can hinder their full potential. So what are these factors you should steer clear of if you want to ensure that Ozempic or Wegovy will work best for you? One common misconception is that any old diet will work perfectly with Ozempic or Wegovy. But the truth is, it's not that simple. While there's no specific diet you need to follow for these medications, studies have revealed an interesting connection between semaglutide, the active ingredient of these drugs, and a reduced desire for fatty foods. It appears that semaglutide may induce a sense of aversion toward fatty foods, possibly due to the increased nausea or difficulties in digesting fats while on the medication. Additionally, a follow-up questionnaire indicated that these medications notably reduce the consumption of savory foods, which are typically rich in fat and salt. This means that traditional low-fat diets may not yield the same level of effectiveness, resulting in less weight loss. It also seems that following a higher-fat diet, such as a keto or high-protein diet, could be a more effective approach when combined with Ozempic or Wegovy. It's worth noting that this wasn't the actual dietary strategy employed by researchers to achieve the impressive results observed in Wegovy's studies. They actually utilized an intensive CICO, or calories in, calories out diet, but that's a topic for another video, which I can link down below in the description if you're interested. Also, if you're curious about what dietary and exercise regimens were used in all of Novo Nordisk's semaglutide trials, as well as how much weight was lost in these trials, we have all that information summarized for you on our Ko-fi page. Check out and support our Ko-fi page for more exclusive content. I've linked the page down below in the description. However, this aversion to fatty foods can be quite intense, particularly when first starting Ozempic or Wegovy. It's important to be aware of this since the aversion can be so strong, some people might experience vomiting. This means that diving straight into a high-fat diet may not be feasible initially, and it's often advised to take it easy on the fat intake in the beginning. To circumvent this issue, my recommendation is to start Ozempic or Wegovy with a diet that aligns well with your preferences and tolerance level, whether that's a low-fat or low-carb approach. This allows your stomach to gradually get used to the medications. As you progress and reach your maximum dose, especially if you notice a weight loss plateau or an increase in appetite, it may be worth considering transitioning towards a moderate to high-fat diet in the long run, as this dietary adjustment could help keep you on track toward your weight loss goals. The second mistake is consuming too many sweet foods. The same studies that investigated the impact of high-fat versus low-fat meals while on these medications also looked into the realm of sweet versus non-sweet foods. What they discovered was that when compared to non-sweet foods, consuming sweet foods consistently led to higher calorie intake during meals. It appears that the presence of sweet foods might slightly counterbalance the aversion to fatty foods induced by the medications. It's also possible that these medications are not as effective at suppressing the intake of sweet foods compared to other flavors. Furthermore, sweet treats can often trigger intense cravings in certain individuals, tempting them to snack or overeat. As a result, overindulging in sweet foods, including those using artificial sweeteners or stevia, may increase your overall food intake while on Ozempic or Wegovy, thereby diminishing the effectiveness of these medications. Now, if you happen to be plagued by sugar cravings or possess a relentless sweet tooth, it's understandable that you might be concerned. However, it's important to recognize that sweet cravings are mostly driven by behavioral patterns and can be effectively addressed through simple behavioral interventions. Studies have shown that if you take the bold step of cutting out sweets entirely, it takes only around 4 weeks for those cravings to noticeably diminish. Also, considering that Ozempic and Wegovy also contribute to suppress sugar cravings to some extent, you may find that eliminating sweets for 4 weeks is not as difficult as you may think. So if you have sweet cravings, my usual recommendation is to try eliminating all types of sweet foods during the first few weeks of starting Ozempic or Wegovy. If that seems too challenging, aim to start the elimination process for at least a couple weeks once you reach the highest dose of semaglutide. Afterwards, your objective should be to minimize your consumption of sweet foods as much as possible. By adopting this approach, you can significantly reduce both your cravings and overall intake of sweet treats, as well as make these medications as effective for you as possible. Another mistake to steer clear of is the temptation to lose weight too rapidly. Some individuals using Ozempic and Wegovy experience such effective appetite suppression that they end up consuming very little food. While this may initially lead to significant weight loss, it can bring about several issues. Firstly, rapid weight loss can increase the risk of hair loss. Although the hair loss is typically temporary, it may take several months for your hair to fully regrow. Furthermore, rapid weight loss can also contribute to the development of what people call Ozempic face. This phenomenon involves a reduction of facial fat, particularly in the cheeks and jawline, resulting in a sagging or aged appearance. The main reason for this is that the facial skin doesn't have sufficient time to readjust and tighten around the lost fat, leading to excess and saggy skin, which makes any wrinkles you have much more noticeable. Naturally, the impact of these effects can vary based on the individual genetics and skin elasticity. Older individuals in particular may experience more Ozempic face than others and struggle to fully regain tightness in their facial skin. So while it may not be possible to completely eliminate the risk of hair loss or Ozempic face when significant weight loss occurs, you can mitigate these concerns by managing the pace of your weight loss. My recommendation is to aim for an average weight loss of around 0.5 to 1% of your current weight per week, which translates to approximately 1 to 2 pounds per week for someone weighing 200 pounds. By maintaining this controlled rate, you can minimize the impact on hair loss and facial appearance, allowing your body and skin to adjust more effectively to your weight loss. Another common issue people on Ozempic and Wegovy run into are nutrient deficiencies. For example, some people end up eating salads all day and don't get enough protein or fat. Your body still needs those nutrients to function, even if you're trying to lose weight. Among patients who have been on Ozempic or Wegovy for an extended period, the most common nutrient deficiencies I've observed are in iron, magnesium, and vitamin B12, although there may be others as well. These deficiencies can lead to various health issues and may even contribute to hair loss. They can also impede your weight loss progress, often leaving patients feeling fatigued, burnt out, and struggling to shed further weight. To combat this problem, it's crucial to maintain a well-balanced diet that incorporates a diverse range of protein sources, such as chicken, fish, nuts, seeds, lentils, and beans. It's essential to avoid overly restrictive diets that deprive you of vital nutrients. While these deficiencies may not manifest immediately, they can gradually sneak up on you if you're not careful. The use of supplements is also a viable option. Preemptively taking magnesium and B12 supplements is generally safe as long as you don't have any kidney issues. However, for iron supplementation, I always recommend getting your iron levels checked first, as excessive iron intake can lead to serious health problems. If you are iron deficient, taking an iron supplement may be a more convenient approach for some individuals, rather than trying to increase their dietary intake of fatty red meats, especially since Ozempic or Wegovy can cause aversion to these foods. Yet another mistake to avoid is neglecting to incorporate exercise into your weight loss journey with Ozempic or Wegovy. While these medications can indeed lead to significant weight loss on their own, exercise remains a vital component of your overall weight loss strategy. There are several reasons why exercise is important. Firstly, it helps to elevate your metabolism by preserving or building lean muscle mass, ultimately enhancing your long-term weight loss results. Additionally, exercise mitigates the risk of muscle and bone loss that can occur during drastic weight reduction, although this concern is more relevant for older individuals using Ozempic or Wegovy. If you find that your weight loss has plateaued and you're feeling sluggish and unmotivated, it may be time to incorporate exercise to get things moving again. My recommendation is for patients to initiate some form of exercise routine as soon as their body has adjusted to the medication and are no longer experiencing frequent vomiting or nausea. If you want to follow the footsteps of the research studies, you can begin with approximately 100 minutes of moderate intensity exercise per week, spread across 4 to 5 days, then gradually increase it to 200 minutes per week. I have some videos about how to start exercising for weight loss, and I'll link those down below in the description. Ozempic and Wegovy are powerful medications for weight loss, but many of the things you do while on these drugs will impact their effectiveness. It's important to keep this in mind if you want to make the best use of these GLP-1 agonists. Hi, I'm Dr. Brian Young. Do you have any things or mistakes to avoid while using Ozempic or Wegovy? Let me know in the comments down below. Subscribe and hit the notification bell if you want to stay up to date. And if you found this informative, please leave me a like and share this video with someone you know can use the info.